everyone. Libby and I have come into the back paddock, and we have Lily with us, Archie's with us, and Ruby's with us, and we are going to plant this beautiful young Kauri tree.
Lily, come here, girl.
Ru,
come here.
And so I'm going to start digging a hole in a minute, and we are going to bless the ground, even though actually the ground is already blessed, but we are going to create a beautiful space for this Kauri tree and do a blessing for her so that she will grow to be big and strong and not get any infections. That's what we're hoping. We're actually going to plant more Kauri trees as well. So bear with me because I've got to dig a hole now. This soil is actually very clay, so I'm hoping that she will be fine here. And we're right next to the bush. All across here at the back there, and all across here is all bush. Good health, peace and love rain down upon this earth. And it's rather fitting, keep going, because tonight is the full moon and lunar eclipse. So beautiful, beautiful energy day. To start her off, we feel that she's a she. We've tuned in. So she's a feminine vibration. And it's our energy going into this, hence why I'm digging the hole. From the house and Libby's own hand starting it off. So there is a lot of unity consciousness and energy going into planting this beautiful tree. And it's funny because when I saw her at the tree fair we went to the other Saturday, I felt an instant connection to her. And when I've come across other Kauri trees, I have received messages from them. So I feel particularly connected to the Kauri Tree of New Zealand. I don't particularly know why, just the Kauri, but it seems to be at this stage the Kauri. It could be because of the Kauri dieback that's happening. So I've particularly become in tune with that because it really saddens me. So we're going to plant more on this property. Now, this is looking good. This is going to put muscles on me as well. Keep me fit. Quite dug through to England yet, but we've got a nice big hole. And I'll just loosen up the bottom. It's very clayey, so I've got some nice compost to go in. At one time or another, this whole paddock would have been natural bush. So even in this clay soil, once they're established, they will be fine. So let's get some compost. Compost has already got lovely worms in it. I'm just getting scissors. Okay. Did you want to come over here as well, Lib, or not? While we put her in?
What, and play? Or not?
Or just yourself, you know. So I'm just going to move her a bit closer because that's a lot of beautiful soil already around her. So you hold her out. I'll get the stake.
Oh, do you want to take
Ethan? Yeah.
And the stake?
Yeah, because that needs to be cut. He said that. Actually, we need a tie, which we haven't got. I'll come back later to tie her up. I'll just start this off and then. Then we just have the soil.
Which way is she going to lean?
We want her up, up.
Yeah, I know, but if you want to lean. Yes.
Yeah, that way.
Up against where she's going to fall, definitely. While you go and get. Let go, look. She's gonna lean on that then.
Right. Exactly about right,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
So if you can just hold her over there. Start this off. that'll do until we can get a longer one.
Yeah.
And I'll come up, tie her up later. We'll just dig some of that soil back in. She's going to look beautiful. There. Right. You want to come join in with your energy as well on a spade? Let's put lots of blessings and good nutrients, love, peace, so that she may stand for hundreds of years. Way beyond our timeline in the physical. I'll just put some of that other back in there now, because then we can put the clouds up a bit.
Lily, come. Lily,
and then I'll just put this on to the top. And I'm going to sing for her, I think.
You want me to play?
Yeah, that'd be good. Make sure she's nice and firm. A little bit more though, she's got to be a bit firmer or the wind's going to blow her over. Thank you. and any loved ones who wish to come in now. We also call in the ancient ones and the tribal elders to come in for this blessing, for this beautiful Kauri tree. Has come out, the breeze just got up then. Beautiful. So I will just show you where the view that this our beautiful Kauri tree has got, and this is the view she has. So she will be stood as the guardian at the top of this bank, looking out from this point down at the trees down there in the gully. That's where we have magical experiences with nature spirits. There's glowworms and all sorts down there, so she'll be looking over those, and she'll be looking over the land here. And as I pan round, you'll be able to see that this is where the bush is. It's all commented. It's totally untouched. There's a beautiful group of trees here to keep her company. And there's Libby, and there's bush that comes right the way around here. Oh, and we have a fantail here with us. Beautiful. And there it is. Flitting about, coming in to be with us. And there is Archie and Ruby, and Lily is down there having a good sniff around. And look at that beautiful bush, and the sun has come out to shine upon us as we planted her. Beautiful, just here. Much love to you all. Have a wonderful day. from me and Libby. Have a beautiful night tonight under the full moon. Lots of love. Bye.